Hello, my dear student. How are you? Hope everyone is fine. Yes? Okay. First, you take care of yourself as well as you have to take care of your parents. Don't go out because you know what situation we all are facing. Yes? You have completed my work, what I had told in the previous class. Yes or no? Okay, very good. Everyone has tried to complete the work. Okay. Okay, so just I will recall what we had learned in the previous class. Yes, we had learned a large numbers, 6 to 7 digit. Again, we had learned 8 digit numbers and the place value of that all the digit number. Even we had learned the write the number name of it. Yes, how to write the number name? Anybody? Okay, yes, when the number is given, first we have to insert the comma. We have to find its place value and we have to read it and we have to write that number. So, everyone, please remove your book and sit with this class. What we are going to learn today is my kind request to all the students that please pay attention when teacher is teaching in the class. So, your concept will be clear and you will understand what the magic or ideas or tricks teacher is explaining in the class. Yes? Now, can we start? Okay. So, today we are going to start with an ascending and descending of a number. What is ascending of a number? Yes, many a time we had done in the class. Yes, your teacher says that stand in a line according to your height. Means what? Yes, that is nothing but you are standing according to the height is an ascending number. Means smaller number to bigger number. That is ascending number. What is descending number then? Yes, vice versa. Means it's reverse of that. Yeah, the descending number means big to small number. First, now you in the previous class, third standard, fourth standard, you had learned the ascending and descending numbers. Yes, I know very well. But here we are going to have a more than 6 to 7 digit numbers for ascending and descending. So, small tricks I will give to you how to find out without reading the whole number and how to write it ascending and descending number. Yes, we will see our side already had given one, two examples over here. One example, arrange in ascending and descending number. The name numbers what I had given here is that number only we have to arrange in one time in ascending order and one time in descending order. You might be thinking that why teacher has written 8, 9, 9, 8. What I had done? One small magic I had done, just I had counted that all the digits and I had written the number of digits under it. Similarly, you can count these all the digits and you can write with a pencil and you can start your answer with the help of pen, which will be more easy to write. Here, I had written some 8, 9, 9, 8 means what? It is 8 digit number, then second is 9 digit number. Third is 9 digit number and fourth number is of 8 digit number. Yes, so first is AO means what? It is an ascending order. First ascending order means it's small to big. So first we write a small number with a 8 digit number. But here we are having 2 8 digit number. In this we have to find which is smallest 8 digit number. So, which will be the smallest 8 digit number? Here we are having this is also 8 digit number. Here we are having what I told in the previous class, first we have to see the 2 digits in the starting is a 1 8 and here is we are having 9 9. So, which will be greater? Yes, this is greater. First we are writing ascending means our number, first number will be 1 8 6 5 3 4 9 6. Yes, you are right. First, out of these 2 8 digit numbers, we had find out which is smaller. So, we are writing here smaller because it is ascending. Then next will be 8 digit number. Yes, then we are writing this digit number 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 8 times. Now, third digit we have to find. This is also 9 digit. This is also 9 digit. Then how to find out which is smaller out of this? Yes, first we will see this 2 digit number, this is 33 and here it is 43. Which is smaller? Yes, 33 is smaller, and we know this, all the numbers behind that. Here 43 is greater than 33, so we are writing ascending means this will be our third digit, this third number, and this will be our last number, that is 96. So what is our first? It is 1865-3496 is first number. Insert the comma, then it is 9999998 time. This is second, and what will be our third? 3385-3489-6 is our third number, and this is our last, that is fourth number in ascending order. Already I told what will be in the descending order. This is descending order. Here will be reverse. First we have to write a greater number. This is our greater number, am I right? First we will write this number here, then we write again 9 digit number. After this is 33, 85, 34, 896, and third number will be out of this, which is greater. Yes, this is greater. So we will write this number as the third place, and this will be the smaller, which will be written at the last. So in the one number only, we are writing ascending order as well as descending order. First, what we have to do? First we have to count the number of digits, write with a pencil with a small handwriting, and you can find out number of digits, so it will be more easy to compare this, and you will write with a pen what is ascending and what will be the descending numbers. Yes, everyone understood? So you can prepare your own numbers. You can prepare here 6 digit, 7 digit, 8 digit, 9 digit number of your choice, and you can solve this example, create new example of your own and write ascending and descending order. Now very simple, that is a largest and the smallest. You know we had learned a largest number last year also, and this year also in the starting, in the previous class we had learned a largest 8 digit number, but we had given a trick to how to find out the smallest from the largest. So we will write here a largest first. What will be the largest 8 digit number? Largest 8 digit number what will be the? It will be 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. It will be largest 8 digit number. Insert the comma after 3 digit, insert the comma after 2 digit, again after 2 digit insert the comma. So this is a largest 8 digit number, and we will see what is a smallest 8 digit number. Here 8 digit means we will write 1, including the 1 it should be 8 digit. This is 1, this will be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. So after 3 digit insert the comma, after 2 digit insert the comma, and after 2 digit insert the comma. So here is the largest 8 digit number, and this is smallest 8 digit number. What will be the 9 digit number? Largest 9 digit number means we have to write 9 times 9, that is largest 9 digit number. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. After 3 digit insert the comma, after 2 digit insert the comma, after 2 digit insert the comma. This is largest 9 digit number, and we will see a smallest 9 digit number. So this is your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. We have to write 0 as you know that it is a smallest 9 digit. So what is the difference here? Here we are getting as a 9 crores in an 8 digit number. In the 9 digit number we are getting 99 crores. Here in the smallest digit we are having, or 8 digit we are having 1 crore, here we are having 10 crore. So just see the number of digits. It is 8 digit number or 9 digit number. According to this, you have to write largest 8 digit numbers and smallest 8 digit numbers. I think so everyone understood this, because you had learned this in the your previous class also. Just you when it is largest, you have to write 9999, and it is smallest, you have to go for 1000. How many digit number we have to create. Now, using given digits, write a smallest and largest numbers. Use each digit once. Now, what is this? This is very simple. I will give one small trick to you. Here we have to prepare a numbers are given to us. Numbers are given to us, that is nothing but a digits. It is 3, 4, 6, 0, 9 and 8. Now, out of this we have to prepare smallest digit and one will be the largest. What will be that? We have to write as first, I will give one small trick. 0 will be not in a starting, because you know 0 is a very smallest, but we have to write first a natural number, then only we have to write as a 0. So here it is in the smallest digit number we had written as 3 is the smallest out of this. Yeah, you some are saying 0. Yes, you are right, but we have to start with a whole natural number, not by whole number. So we are writing 3, then 0, then out of this 4 is smaller, then 6 is smaller, and 8 and 9. Just we had written these all the numbers, we how many it is, 6 digits are there, we had written that together and we form a number. Yes, we have to not insert the commas here, we have to write all the numbers together. What will be the largest? The reverse of this, but it's not actually reverse. Yes, because we have to take the care of 0 first. So what is the largest? We have to start with a large digit, is your 9, then after that is 8, then 6, then 4, then 3 and 0. You can't write as 0, 3. Got it? So here will be the reverse of this. So everyone understood what are the largest and smallest number. Now, international place value chart. What is international? We are living in India and we have to study international. Yes, we have to study the international numbers and the place value of it, because when you will be grow up, then you will go for the higher studies, you will go for some business with other countries. That time you should know what are the numbers, how they read the numbers, and what are the place value of the given international system. So you should read that numbers, not in like Indian system. We use as Indian system as and crores, lakhs. We don't use here as crores and lakh. We are using here in the international system as a millions, then we go for the thousands and we go for ones. I will explain in very short, brief and very tricky method, so you will understand. Here in India, what is the difference between the Indian and international system? That in short I will say you. First, here in if the number is given, any number of 6 to 7 digit number, write the number in Indian system, okay. Then after the 3 digit, you have to insert the comma from your right hand side. After 2 digit, you have to insert a comma. Then after 2 digit, you have to insert comma in Indian system. Here in the international system, what it is, after 3 digit, you have to insert the comma. So how to read that number? In short, I will explain you. Here also, we have to start from our right hand side, that is ones, then thousands and millions. So in ones, what it is? Ones, tens and hundred. Yes, you know very well, because you had studying in previous classes. Then you know 1000, 10,000 and 100,000. This is new for you. So this is in a thousand, we have three categories, that is 1000, 10,000 and 100,000. Here under the millions, millions, 10 millions and 100 millions. Here, so here some examples are given. just what we had done in Indian system place value chart, similarly we have to do for the international place value chart. So here I had given some comparison here down. What is a comparison? What will be the numbers equal to in international system? Here 1 lakh is equal to 100,000. 100,000. So here in the international system I had given after 3 digit the comma here, so it is written as 100, and that is in the form of 1000. It is under the 1000, so it is 100,000. 10 lakhs is equal to 1 million. So under the million when we write as a lakh, and 10 lakhs will be 1 million. Then what about the crore? 1 crore is equal to 10 millions. Now see the column of 10 millions when we are writing in our Indian system as 1 crore. Here 10 crores is equal to 100 millions. 100 millions means which will be in 100 place and the zeros will be there. So here we are writing in international system that 100 millions is equal to in Indian system is 10 crores. Yes, is vice versa. You can read it as an international system as well as Indian system. So I have given two examples over here. How to read out the first? Yes, I will read and show you one example so you will understand. Yes, it is 267,813,310. Again, I will repeat, please pay attention. 267,813,310. What about the second? Yes? Yeah. Anybody? Okay. You try. I will just give me the answer within 2 minutes. So here it is 345,970,892. This is international system. How we read and we have to write in a words. And already I had given some comparison, so you will understand the Indian as well as international system. Write the place value of a digit in a red in international system. What I told here already I had showed to you. Here I had done after 3 digit I had insert the comma. Here also I had after 3 digit I had insert the comma. Here is 3 digit. So what is the place value? This is, you know, yes, we had written seen in the previous slide, this is a ones. So here it is ones, tens and 100. So it is 600. What will be here? This is your ones, this is your thousands, yes, and this is your million. So what is the red? 6 is the red. This one is a 6 million. So after 3 digit you have to insert the comma for international system. So what will be the answer of this? Here what will write? Here it is 6 million. Yes, you are right. If it is, I am giving here is an 4 also, it is a million. Okay. Now rounding to the nearest to tens. You know rounding of a number. Again you want to recall. Okay. I will give one small example that when your mother is giving you something 15 rupees and my mother says go and purchase some bananas nearby your house where we are having small fruit and vegetable shop. Okay. So that uncle is saying you it is 12 rupees, you are getting 4 bananas. 12 rupees, 4 banana. What you will say? Uncle, please give not in the 10 rupees 4 bananas. Uncle say, okay beta, no problem, take 4 bananas for 10 rupees. What you have done? Yes, you had used your smart brain and you had done rounding of that number. So 12 rupees you had rounded to 10 rupees. Yes or no? Yes. So the 12 rupees is near to the 10 number or it is near to the 20. Why don't you say that uncle take 20 rupees or 15 rupees and give me 4 banana? You will say no. You have to not do this. You have to first see the amount of that things and just use your brain which number I have to say to get at low cost, or just I will request that uncle that he will give me for the 10 rupees or he will give me for the 12 rupees or 15 rupees. Yes, you have to first ask the cost of the things and then you have to give the money for that when you are purchasing the things. Now here are a very small tricks I will give how to understand the rounding to the nearest 10. One example I told you about that banana, that is uncle fruit shop. So here we are having some similar example on our slide. Here we are having a 26. 26 I had done rounded to 30. Some might be having what, why ma'am has done in this way. I will give small easy trick. Here the 26 is rounded to 30. The number 26 lies between 20 and 30. 26 lies between 20 and 30. 26 is near to 30 or it is near to 20? Okay, it is near to 30. So we have to nearest to tens means tens is a, this one is one digit. So you have to think about this digit. Just listen carefully. I am giving a small trick to you. So you have to think about 10 we are having in tens. So you have to think about only 10. So you have to think about only one digit here. Okay. So here in this you have to see that this digit what I had underlined is more than 5 or less than 5. Now 6 is more than 5? Yes. If it is more than 5, we have to go to the higher digit, or if it is 5, then also we have to go to higher digit. So 26 will be a nearest to 30. What I had done, when I am going for the higher digit, I had put the 0, I had add a 1 to the before number. What I had done, I had add 1 to the before number. One more example we will see here, 132. Now this number lies between 130 and 140. What I told, when it is tens, we have to see 10, so we have to see the single digit. So which is, it is more than 5 or it is 5 or it is less than 5. If this digit is less than 5, we have to do as the nearest to this will be 32 is nearest to 30, not and 40. So what will be the nearest number of this? You have to put the 0. So nearest number of 132 will be 130. What we had done? We had learned about the first tens. Here we are seeing the digit which should be 5, less than 5 or more than 5. Now one more example we will see. We had learned about the tens, then we will see about the hundreds. Nearest, rounding nearest to 100. What it is? Here it is 839. We have to find out it is nearest to 100. The example here is given something different. Here is 839. Which will be the nearest 100? 100 means we are having a 20. We have to think about this 20, which is more than 50 or it is less than 50. Yes, it is less than 50 because we have to consider only the two digits because we are rounding up to 100. So here we will be considering two digits. Is this number, the 39, is less than 50 or more than 50? I told it's, we have to see 500 in this way. So here is less than, so I have to write is as a 800. Now one more, this is 3 digit. We will go for another example of an 4 digit number. Now again my question is nearest 100. 100 means 20. So I will underline these 2 digits. I have to find out these 2 digits are more than 50 or less than 50. What it is? Yes, it is more than 50. I have to add 1 to the before number of this. So, it will be 1300. Just small tricks I had given which will help you to write this number very easily. Just read the question properly. It is nearest to 100, nearest to tens, nearest to 1000, what it is. Now, another example which will be here is given as a nearest to 1000. What will be the nearest to 1000? So, here 4839. 1000 means, you know how we are writing, this is 1000. So, I am giving a small trick to you. So, we are having 3 zeros in 1000. Yes. So, we have to underline these 3 digit and we have to find out what will be the next number rounding of the 4839. What will be this? Yes. Is this number more than 500? Yeah. It is more than 500. So, we have to add to 1 to the before number of this and write the 0. So, what will be here? It will be 5000. It will be 5000. When it is a 5 or more than 5, we are going to next. Now, I have taken the example of 2500 or to 2500. Here, I am having a more than or 500 or more than 500. Just we have to add 1 to the before number. So, here we are having a 500. I will add 1 to before number. So, it will be 1000. So, it will be 3000. So, here rounding nearest to 1000 and rounding nearest to 10,000. Similarly, what we have to see in 10,000, how many zeros? 4 zero. So, we have to underline 4 the digits and we have to find out what will be the number to that rounding of that number. This all what I had explained should be first revise, do your own numbers, write your, create your own examples and do it. Now, we will switch off to Roman numbers. Yes. What is Roman? I am not going for Roman. No, we are going to learn a Roman number. So, and where these numbers are useful? Yes, everyone is having big question in front of us. Where we are using this number? Anyone? Yes, we are having this number in our clock or in our watches, or we are writing this number on the grades, in which grade you are studying. I am studying in 5th grade, means I write as a V. I am studying in 10th standard, 10th grade, I am writing X. In short, I will explain you what are this. Here, we are having a place value in our Indian and international system. But Roman number, we don't use the place value. This is the difference between the Indian system and the Roman numerals. We don't have a place value over here. So, here we are having 1, so capital I as a 1, 5 we write as a V, 10 we write as X, 50 we write as L, 100 we write as a C, 500 we write as D, and 1000 we write as M. What we have to, this we have to, yes, we have to learn it. Yes, without this, we can't remember or we can't write the in Roman number as well as in Hindu Arabic system. I will explain in my next class what are the Roman numbers, how to convert Roman number in a Hindu Arabic system or Hindu Arabic number into Roman system, Roman numeral. So, I think so, my dear student, everyone understood what I had taught today. Yes, we had learned in brief, we will see, we had learned rounding of numbers. Yes, yeah, we had learned international place value chart. Please do practice of this. After 3 digit, we have to insert a comma for international place value chart and you have to create your own number and prepare a question for this, and you can take a help of your textbook for solving the example. Be prepared for my next class. Yes, have a nice time. Thank you. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.